And talking about what we're looking forward to in 2015. Now, you
January 23rd when the exams are finished, that's when you're recording.
But Broadchurch on ITV returned last night after a second series.
What is the story about?
Okay, now, the first series was all about, well, most people know this, but the first series was about a little boy being found dead on the beach.
A murder most foul.
Yes.
Yes.
And then David Tennant, who has done a lot of Shakespeare, turns up and he's a detective and he tries to find the killer with someone, Coleman. Yeah. What's her name?
Oh, I seen it this morning. Olivia something, I think.
Olivia Coleman.
Yeah.
She's fantastic. She's probably the best actress there. And then David Tennant, he's equally as good. And it's just all about, it's 10 episodes of trying to find the killer and all these secrets are revealed. And it's, the tension is kept. The acting is fantastic. And then the killer is revealed at the end. And then they said series 2 is coming. And
it's all wrapped up in a nice little bow.
Yeah.
And series
it's
2.
It's done. All the characters can move on. You're like, What the blaze is the season 2 going to be about? And it's simple.
Disappearance.
Yeah, give me a tenner. The first series introduced David Tennant's character, camera detective something, and
we call him John.
He had quite a rough background.
Yeah.
He's notorious for failing this major case.
Well, everybody makes the odd screw up now, but
the odd mess up. But he's notorious for this case that he messed up a couple of years back. And season 2 kind of picks up where season 1 left off, where the killer is now on trial.
Mm.
And instead of saying all the evidence proves that he's guilty,
yeah,
but instead of saying guilty in court, he says non-guilty. Ooh. Which means instead of a sentencing, they have to go through an entire court process.
Oh, that's not
so good. The series is going to follow this court battle, but also like the sneaky lawyer of the killer.
Yeah.
But I mean, like, they're all human characters, but she's trying to set this person free and she's going to try and manipulate the evidence.
Ooh.
So it's all about keeping this killer behind the bars while David Tennant tries to deal with this this past, with this course that has come back to haunt him.
Yeah.
Because the man that he accused has now set up camp in the village.
Oh.
And David Tennant is so confident that this guy's a murderer. So you've got a murderer who's free, and you got a murderer who David Tennant is trying to put behind the bars, and you got a murderer who's trying to get in front of the bars, like he's trying to leave.
Yeah.
He's trying to get away with it. So
interesting. For the listeners,
it hasn't got the hook. They're like, oh, we're trying to find the killer. It hasn't got the hook of season 1, but my God, that first episode didn't
court
let you down.
It was very
well done, very well acted. The emotions, it looks stunning. The series is stunning, and there are some shocking scenes in it.
Court battles can be very interesting. I remember watching Boston Legal. Did you ever see it?
I've heard of it, yeah.
William Shatner and James Spader is in it. I have to say, some of their monologues for that are absolutely fantastic.
Mm.
Some of the things they pull are just hilarious and yet still thought-provoking.
Yeah.
Like, in general, the series, it's a bit bad. Like, but I enjoy watching it. It's bad television. You can just kind of sit there and relax and watch it. But some of the things they do, like James Spader, fantastic actor. He was in The Blacklist recently.
Yeah, and he's...
Did you see it at all?
He's going to be Ultron in Avengers 2.
I think that's a great choice.
Yeah.
Because he has the gravitas. He has the evil, the brooding, the menace. Oh, great actor. I do love you, Spader.
So I've got, you know, we've got Broadchurch, currently watching it, and then you have the new season of The House of Cards that's coming out
27th of February. I cannot wait. I'm happy with season 2.
And then you got the second part of the new series of The Walking Dead coming out.
I've never seen it, though.
I love it. And then you got the Breaking Bad spin-off, Better Call Saul.
I didn't watch Breaking Bad either, so
yeah. I'll make the effort to try and watch this one, because I didn't get to see Breaking Bad.
I'll probably just binge on Netflix.
I was introduced to the first episode, and then probably a few days later I was introduced to the last episode. So I pretty much had to fill in the gaps.
I think something happened in the middle of it, about meth, maybe. That
probably
had something to do with it.
I think there was some sort of explosion in there. Maybe a gunfight. I'm not
maybe
sure.
Once or twice, I don't know. It's not something that I know.
I think
about.
He shaved his head at one point.
I think he grew a great beard, I have to say.
Like
a really, yeah, really nice. I think. I don't know. There's definitely no evidence in this room for any kind of thing for it.
Nope. So, 2015 there's a lot to look forward to in film and television.
It does. A lot.
So we've been gone.
We didn't even talk about the Avengers film. That's coming out this year, I think.
Yeah, don't worry, we'll be getting that. Don't worry, don't worry.
Great.
We've been gone over Christmas. A lot of stuff was announced over Christmas. First things first, there's a new Rambo film coming.
I seen that. I think it
was Rambo, Last Blood. It's gonna star Sylvester Stallone.
Sylvester Stallone, I don't
know. What's that, Rambo? I can
tell you. Guns.
Okay. It's not about how hard you can hit, it's about how hard you can get hit and keep going.
Of course, Lester Bowen was gonna hit really hard.
I mean, my God, he was like those Rocky films. They present how good he can write, and then the Rambo films and the Expendable films show how bad he can write.
Yeah, the Expendable films, they're enjoyable, but
I love the premise.
The premise is fantastic.
I love that. Just bring all these 80 action, 80
and 90s too.
Yeah. I'll bring all these action stars together and then make them blow up stuff, and it's great. But
It's a feel-good family romp. That's what it is. It's not something to be analysed and technically assessed. It's just there.
Expendables 3 brings in the young folk. They're like, oh, we must appeal to a younger audience. Let's bring in these four younger people, and you're just like... And do you know why they did that? Because of Twilight.
Because of Twilight?
F you, Twilight. No one likes Twilight. They're like, oh, they want Robert Pattinson in these action films now. Like,
Robert Pattinson's going to be in it?
No, no, he's not.
Oh, thank
God. But they wanted a Robert Patterson type young actor.
Did they throw in?
They threw in a guy called Killian Lutz, who no one had ever heard of.
Who?
Yeah, no. They brought in four young actors no one had ever heard of, because they wanted to say, oh, we want to start their action careers. That didn't happen.
Or Sylvester Stallone.
What has happened to him? And like Arnold Schwarzenegger, who's not at the governor anymore. He has more time to himself. He made a cameo.
More time for them gains. That's what it is.
He made a cameo in Expendables 2. And you think, oh, well, we can have more of them in Expendables 3. We can have Sylvester Stallone and Arnold Schwarzenegger right next to each other, shooting guns and barrels and blowing stuff together and quipping off each other, which would be great.
Shooting red barrels, of course.
Because, that necessarily wasn't the case with Escape Plan. And
didn't see it, no.
Yeah. They kind of just talk. They punch a few people and they shoot a few guns, but they're never really like next to each other, like blowing things away. And again, he's a cameo in Expendables 3, and you actually, it's one of those films.
Wasted.
It's one of those films, just like, okay, I want more Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Of course, like, Arnold Schwarzenegger's... He's not a fantastic actor, but he knows what he's doing.
Yeah.
He's good for the kind of role he does.
Yeah.
So, and, hulking
like,
man.
There's this bit where, Harrison Ford turns up in the chopper and he just starts mowing down hundreds of bad guys in his class.
That's in the trailer, isn't it?
Yeah, Arnold Schwarzenegger, he's got this big, massive gun on him. I don't know what it is, but he just starts shooting it, and he takes down an entire chopper with this gun.
That's a big ass gun.
But he does something we've never seen before. He's like, he's blowing them away.
There's a backflip? What?
No, he's blowing them away. But as he does it, he laughs his head off.
That's sadistic.
Never done that before. He's always been straight faced shooting the guns. Just what he's laughing his head off while he does it. And that wasn't like the big selling point of the film, but it was like 2 seconds long, and I thought that was great. I thought that was a nice little touch.
Oh, yeah.
But to me, Expendables 3 was a bit of a letdown. Did you hear about all this hacking business with the interview?
With the interview, yes. How could you not?
Yeah, I mean, like, it's impossible not to hear about it.
Sony.
And North Korea was going to bomb America and vice versa.
North Korea, the nuclear bomb wouldn't blow up Central Park in New York that far.
I could just see them, like, trying to launch it, and it goes... This is really sparking. The mouse goes... This kind of goes out like a firework. Like a dud firework.
Probably would just...
And I was kind of...
Nick Fire will probably do more damage. More than likely.
And so it was like a week before the film was due to be released, they pulled it in America.
I think somehow that was marketing.
And they were like, no, we're going to pull it because there's threats to theatre chains, and theatre chains are starting to pull the film. And then 3 days before the film was due to release, they said, no, actually, we're going to show it.
Yeah.
And they showed
it. I think it was marketing, that play. I think that was good, very good marketing.
The film was cancelled and then uncancelled a day before the film was released, and it made $1 million in the box office.
Of course it did, because
it was shown in very little theatres. It had a limited release
but it's being released now to a wider audience.
Yes.
And it's being released on the internet as well.
It was released on Google Play, YouTube, and iTunes, I think. You had to buy them or rent the film, and it made like 15 million in the first couple of days.
because of all the publicity and everyone to see
because
it.
Of all the publicity, and that's via online, that's YouTube, and yeah. They made 15 million from that. So the film is, considering the circumstances, a huge success.
Yeah, considering it,
it's all about
nearly started World War III, but yeah, success.
It's all about the freedom of speech, and like the film was released and nothing they can do about
Kim
it.
Jong-un
it's done.
Kim Jong-un is not pleased with Obama now.
Oh, no.
Call him a monkey.
Obama's not pleased with Kim Jong-un.
He was the father.
That's what actually there's a point I had. Team America. Who's the bad guy in Team America?
Korean dude. I can't remember his name.
Kim Jong-un. Kim Jong-un's father.
Did they change the name around a wee bit?
No, it's Kim Jong-un. Yeah. And in the film, he turns out to be the bad guy, and he... And then he gets stabbed in the heart, and he turns out to be a cockroach. And like film wasn't banned.
That film was... That was a bad film. Enjoyable, but...
Team America, like, that was one of the... To me, is one of the best comedy films ever.
It's hilarious, but it's...
Oh, the Film Actors Guild is just F-A-G. Alec Baldwin, F-A-G.
Alec Baldwin.
Matt Damon.
I can't even think of his name without thinking that just
Matt Damon. Eric Bowen.
Bowen.
You're a terrible actor. The film is eventually released. I think it's coming here on the 9th of February.
I couldn't tell you now.
Yeah. Something like that there, I'm not really sure. And also, they released at the end of the year, like, the highest viewed trailers of the year. And guess which was number one?
Probably The Hobbit, was it?
No, not even close.
Not even close? No. Jesus. It wouldn't be the end of the year anyway, because it was just kind of...
No. Think of the big films of 2015.
Of 2015. Yeah. Maybe it's either going to be Star Wars or Avengers.
Star Wars came second.
What?
Avengers came third.
What's top dog?
You will not believe it.
What is it?
50 Shades of Grey.
Oh, right. That makes more sense now, actually.
Yeah. It only got more views than Star Wars because it was released like 4 months earlier.
Yeah, Star Wars. Give Star Wars time to catch up.
I think Star Wars is pretty much, it's on the passing point, pretty much. Star Wars, I think at the end of the year, had like 50 million views or something like that. Yeah. I think the 50 Shades of Grey was like 63.
That film's going to make some money.
And then Avengers was like 40 something.
All the middle-aged women going to see the film with their husbands on Valentine's Day. They planned that well.
I could not care for the film.
I don't care for the film.
I don't care for the film.